My name is Dr. Michel Dion. I am an animal health scientist with the International Livestock Research Institute. I'm based in Kampala in Uganda. I am working in the smallholder pig value chain in Uganda since 2012, a project which is hosted by the CGR Livestock and Fish program. One year ago, I started using gender studies to in order to mainstream them in my research. And the reason why I started mainstreaming my research is that I thought it was interesting and really very critical to assess gender dimension in a pig husbandry and disease control in order to inform our intervention in reducing pig diseases in Uganda. So basically, the topic for my study is gender dimension in pig husbandry and disease control using the case of African swine fever. As you may know, African swine fever is the disease, the most feared disease in the pig system in Uganda because its high mortality rate and also the fact that there is no vaccine and there is no cure for the disease. And this is an endemic disease in Uganda and other African countries. And also knowing that women are well invested in pig production in Uganda, it was critical to study the gender dynamics in relation to pig disease and pig husbandry in order to inform intervention. The whole process started 1 year ago with the coaching from the kit team and all the ILRI colleagues who are gender scientists. The study was conceived by myself and other colleagues, and the tools to mainstream gender were supported by gender specialists from ILRI and then from the kit team. Basically, what we did was to undertake some field work using focus group discussion and intra-household survey to have information that was later on analyzed with gender experts to make sense of it and also to contribute to the interventions. So some of the main findings that we think could really significantly guide our intervention were: number one, there are differences in gender roles and relation at the household level. Women are mostly involved in in-house tasks like cleaning, wiping, cooking, swill, feeding the pigs, watering the pigs, while men are more involved in the post-farm nodes like the marketing and then access to, sourcing for veterinary services. That is one of division which was clear. But interestingly, when there is outbreak like the case of African swine fever, there seems to be a shift in roles and relation. There seem to be more joint activity implementation in the household. And this is probably driven by the fact that there is a risk, economic risk and also social risk, which is associated to African swine fever, which makes men and women really do anything they used not to do in order to eradicate the disease and gain most about piggery. Then this finding is very interesting to be adapted in our training, because it will help us now see how who to target during the trainings. And for this case, we are suggesting that during trainings in disease control in livestock or in the pig systems, it's better to target both men and women at the same time, so that if one of them is not available at the time of the disease or the outbreak, another one could cover. Another finding which is really interesting was that the fact that it's very important to have a take-home message after the training. Whoever attended the training should have a take-home message in a written way, or like a poster or a leaflet or something that could inform the other people at home who did not attend the training. And most importantly, if the woman attended, this could be a proof of attendance to a training to the husband, to avoid domestic violence. And another third interesting finding is that ownership of the animals was also a factor that was a factor that could guide, I mean, the attendance to the training, especially for women. So if women own pigs, so they could make a stronger case to attend training. But if they did not own pig, then the attendance was lowered by the fact that they don't own pig. So the ownership of the animal is really important.